Yeah, we're getting that snow today. A little bit coming down. Not too much yet. Just the dusting. I don't know how this is going to turn out. We'll take you for a little trip. Well, I better turn that off. We'll have copyright infringements. Now we'll just sit you on the dash. Take you for a ride. Like I say, we're not getting too much yet. It's just starting. Still see where I plowed there yesterday. Not too much. Probably get the boom over tonight. See you by tomorrow. We were just running to the general store, just up the road. Not going really too far, not doing too much. Just thought, I'll take you guys for a ride, see how it turns out. Not sure if I'm going to post it or not, but we'll see. This is my old beater van. It's a go to work and back. Kind of like the best one A's car, just a cheap secondhand vehicle, just to do my running. I hate spending lots of money on a vehicle, especially up here. They get rusted out so fast with the salt on the road and that kind of thing. So I'm like the best one A. I just get something cheap and run it into the ground. Nothing. No sense in spending a lot of money on something just to let it rust away. Run up there for the snow. You're wondering why the road's all melted off. It's because they got it covered in salt. Where it's good to keep the road clear, but it sure eats the crap out of your vehicle. You can just hear it rusting away. Screaming, little screams. Yeah, it's not nice to vehicles at all. Just eats the rocker panels and fenders and that kind of stuff right off. And then after a while you get holes in the floor, and then you can use them pretty Flintstone layer brakes there and stick your feet out. Not good. Like I say, that's why I don't bother buying new vehicles. They don't last. Not in the salt and stuff in the winter. So I like the best one A there, just get an old beater and put the kilometers on it. When you're done, get rid of it. Actually, liked his video the other day there when he was working on his car. I used to do that all the time when I was younger. I still do it now that I'm older. I don't like it as much. It used to be fun, but now it's just a chore. But it's good. It's good to have skills like that, and work on your own stuff. It's expensive to take it to the ground or to the garage. Like if the best one took his car there for that head gasket or rings or whatever's wrong with the compression there in that one cylinder. If he took that to the garage, that'd probably cost him $3,000 or $4,000. Like I said, he didn't even, I think he said he spent $700 or something like that on the car. So you're not going to take it to the garage and spend over four times what you bought the car for. Like, that's just silly. But I like to see people working on their own stuff like that. It's a good way to do it. You learn, you might not know everything. You do a little research when you start into it. It's really not that hard. You just have to start at it and go. Same with the motorcycles. You take them into the garage, man, they can cost you a fortune for little jobs. Like in the spring there when I did my starter, we got to pull the side off, we got to do this, we got to do that. And it's not that big of a job. You buy the gaskets, check into it and you go for it. Like anybody that's a little bit mechanically inclined, no big deal. So, yeah, I enjoyed, he's got some more videos to come, of course, but I like to see that. I like to see people working on their stuff and doing it themselves. It's, I really like that. So, right on there, the best one. Camera took a tumble. Brakes a little too fast. Get in here off the highway. Anyway, like I was saying, I really like that. People working on their own stuff and getting her done. So, here's to you, boys. Take care. Bye-bye.